Welcome to Bodacious Babes Binge Barbie Movies.
Yeah.
This is the third and probably final episode because
The final day of Majora's Mask.
Oh, no, the final day.
Majora's Mask, The Legend of Zelda.
Yeah, I know. I said the last episode was probably the final one, but this is for real this time, probably. Yeah. So this time we watched. I don't have anything pulled up, so I just
watched another Barbie movie.
Yeah, do you
guys gonna guess?
Do you remember which one? You got this.
Barbie meets Tinkerbell.
No,
because they had fairies.
I mean, yeah. It's Barbie Fairytopia. You know,
they just
love fairies. I wanted to get Cam to watch it, but Cam is fake and he refused to watch it. So we got good old trusty PJ.
I will
on the
always
show
be going
for
to
the
watch it.
For the last time.
Yeah.
Next time, if there is a next time, PJ will not be allowed on the show.
Well, it's not like anybody else is gonna be willing to watch it, so you'll have to ask me again.
No, I'm just gonna do a solo show and it'll be really awkward. Yeah, so we watched Barbie Fairytopia, and off the bat, I thought it looked probably worse than Diamond Castle, but not too much better than Princess and the Pauper.
Yeah, I think it was funny how the field, the grass looked like a golf course.
Oh, yeah.
And they had lean on rivers.
Yeah, they did.
Lean rivers. Love lean.
PJ, give a lean review right now.
That's so purple. Oh, what else is purple? Thanos, Mace Windu's lightsaber, Majora's Mask in general. That game is just very purple. What else is purple?
I know. So this is, I think it'd be very funny.
Oh, Bomb Green Goblin has purple on him from Spider-Man.
I think it'd be very
funny. Oh, and the 11th Doctor.
I'm gonna kill you, goddammit!
In Season 7, or Series 7, that's the British way, Series 7B, when he travels with Clara Oswald, he wears a purple suit with
the
bow tie.
I'm cutting out
the
Breath of
the Wild. What's purple on Breath of the Wild?
I'm gonna kill myself!
I'm gonna cut out the
Breath of the Wild,
Okay, I really think it'd be funny if instead of purple, P was yellow. Wouldn't that be funny? Ha ha. Anyway. The movie.
Oh, the spirit orbs.
Oh my god,
Breath of the Wild.
Great
game.
Breath of... God damn it, not Breath of the Wild.
Yes.
Fairytopia, I'm gonna be honest, pretty mid. But there's no butts, no cuts, no coconuts.
Well, I know another butt. No, well, oh yeah, there's not butts, but I know another reason why.
Okay.
There's no music! Where's the singing?
I actually
don't
mind the fact that there's no music, but I don't think the plot made up for that.
We all know what the best song in Barbie is. Sync up the song.
Yeah, I'm not gonna...
I'm just like you! You're just like me!
So there was no music, and instead they had Jeff Bezos pump microplastics into the air to turn everybody's wings atrophy everyone's, I don't know, you know what I mean. So they can't fly anymore.
Man,
real
shame, huge
real
shame.
Very, very real. That's basically what happened, to be fair. Some evil lady pumps gas into the sky, and that makes it so people can't fly anymore. And then she'll be all powerful and control the world's economy.
This chair's so squeaky, by the way.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah, but our heroine, I think her name's Alina.
You take that, Andrew?
No, PJ.
She has no wings because she is disabled, I guess. So the movie.
Oh yeah.
It's a little bit about how what's the word? I don't know, it's showing that even if you have a disability, you can do great things.
Yeah, well, that's what we were talking about. Literally, at the end of the movie, we were like...
So at the end of the movie, the evil lady tempts her by being like, ooh, you can have wings.
Yeah, and
but she does not give in to temptation, but instead deliver us from evil.
But doesn't Amen. She get wings at the end?
No, that's from the Good Witch or something.
Yeah, well, we're saying like, oh, it would have been, we thought it would have been better if she didn't have wings, to, so everyone accepts her for who she is.
Yeah, it feels like
she's different.
Kind of a cop-out. Okay, I know they're going to make sequels, because there's like, not Fairytopia, Mermaidia. And it just like, it was just to sell toys, basically. I thought that was a bit of a cop-out at the end.
Yeah. It's part of the I probably already made this joke, but it's part of the BCU, the Barbie Cinematic Universe.
Yeah, other than that, I thought the villain was just kind of weak, because you didn't really see her interact with the Barbie in question of this universe. Barbie's real challenge in this movie was sort of just, like, walking, for the most part. At most, there would be, like, some evil pterodactyls combined with those enemies from Super Mario Galaxy 2 chasing her, or goblins, like, green goblins.
Yeah!
Or, yeah, you know, there was not much, like, of the main villain.
I'm something of a scientist.
My Kill her!
Wait, I was gonna say, do you know how many miles she walked?
Yeah.
500 miles, then 500 more.
That's not what happened.
Then 1,000 miles, just for the likeness.
They actually confirm in the movie that she walked 42 miles total.
Oh, that's not that much.
Yeah, that's like, you know, someone walked from Tufts to Worcester, I think, which is like, but they didn't actually. They walked to, like, Shrewsbury and then took a cab the rest of the way, like a wimp. All I'm gonna say is that I could have walked,
but whatever, whatever. Oh, let's talk about that little dude.
Oh, not yet.
Oh, okay.
So, in the previous movies, the villains had, like, a much more involved role, like, Princess and the Pauper. The Preminger was, like, very connected, and they interacted a lot with the protagonists, but... Then in the next movie, I definitely don't think they interacted that much, but they felt more threatening because they had, I don't know, there was just more interaction between their minions and stuff. I don't know. But this one, there was, like, barely any connection. The villain felt very, very weak.
Yeah.
Okay, it's time to talk about everyone's favorite part of the movies.
Bibble.
Bibble, I think his name might be Bibble.
Let me check. I think it's Bibble. Well, I know Bibble because the candy, popcorn, and Victorious, and Sam and Cat. You know Cat, she would always eat the Bibble.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
No, this kid didn't grow up on Nickelodeon because he's
I wasn't
too
allowed
young.
To.
Oh, it's Alina with an E. How interesting. Fungus Maximus. There's a fungus among us.
Look at him. I don't know if you can see that, but if you can't, oh well, I'll just edit a picture of her.
Wait, there's a girl Bibble? What?
Spoilers for the next movies. Yeah, Bibble, oh my god. What do you think of him, PJ?
I don't know, he's kind of annoying.
Could you do your best Bibble impression, please? It's pretty accurate, I mean.
Yeah.
He cannot speak, so he sort of just makes stupid noises. And if I'm gonna be honest, I wanted to kick Bibble through the entire movie. His head would squeak if I kicked it. He just looks like it. But every time he showed up, I started laughing.
Yeah, that's the thing. Stupid. If you're a princess, mostly in like a movie, in like a movie with a princess, there you always have to have some sort of animal type companion. So
yeah,
this counted as the animal movies. Companion.
The weird, freaky, whatever it is. I don't know. Also, they called Barbie like slurs at the beginning of the movie because she has no wings.
Andrew liked that part because Andrew loves saying slurs.
I do love saying slurs so much, so much. Here, I'll say one right now.
I noticed that one thing that I did notice about this Barbie movie is that they did have one of the handsome male.
Oh my god.
Protagonists.
He wasn't a protagonist.
He was just kind of a. Yes. Okay. True. In this movie, he was kind of just a background character.
Oh, that reminds me. They defeat Laverna, who's the evil witch, with the power of gay pride. They have a big rainbow and it blows her up or something. Laverna is the GPS telling the gay couple to go straight, and they say never, and they destroy her.
Yeah, I wish the handsome protagonist. Well, he wasn't even. Why do I keep saying that? I wish the handsome guy had more of a role in the movie.
Well, all the seven, or actually, does the rainbow? Yeah, I guess it does.
Like Barbie is very girl power,
and PJ hates that because.
No.
PJ,
no.
Do you think women should be in the kitchen?
What do you mean?
Would you say yes for a second? Do you think Breath of the Wild is the best game ever made?
Do I think Breath of the Wild is the best game ever made?
Yeah.
You're gonna cut it.
I would never do that, Presley. I would never
Breath
cut
of
it.
The Wild. Breath of the Wild.
I would, PJ. If your mom...
Breath of the Wild is the best game ever made.
If your mom was about to be killed and you had to answer yes or no...
Stop asking this. This is stupid. You're just gonna make me say... that to the
I would never
me. Yes you are. No,
if you were to be asked.
Okay, where was Ken in this movie?
Ken, I think this is one of those movies where Ken does not exist.
Why? He's such an important character.
Maybe
in
he was reincarnated as Bibble.
That tells you something. They don't have Ken in an actual Barbie movie, but they have Ken in Toy Story 3.
God,
what's the real Barbie movie then? This? Tinkerbell? Or
Tinkerbell?
What's it called again?
Fairytopia.
Fairytopia or
Toy Story 3. You're awful, PJ. I should kill you. With a rock to the head.
Where was the brown-haired Barbie?
So, yeah, actually, this movie doesn't have a lot of the typical Barbie tropes, I guess, where there's, like, a secondary. So, at the start, there was, like, a ginger who I kind of thought would be the...
Like the second main character?
Yeah, but then she disappeared because
she wanted to go home.
She got too many microplastics in her wing, so, yeah. Then there was this stupid butterfly who was stupid. I didn't like him because he looked stupid. His hair is actually just a texture. It's not even, like, modeled.
Yeah.
And then there was a mermaid, actually. A mermaid guy.
Oh, yeah, that's me.
Because he's a Sinbad. Yeah, but that was actually really strange, because they sort of just swam, and then disappeared. That's like setting up something in the MCU. It like shows up for 1 second, and then there's a whole another movie about it. That's Barbie Mermaidia.
Man, why is Barbie copying the MCU? The MCU came out first.
Actually, that's not true, PJ. The MCU actually started in 2008, and this movie came out in 2005, meaning the MCU.
First Iron Man. That was the first one.
That's not an Iron Man.
Well, technically
that's a Black
now,
Sabbath song.
Technically now, the Holy Trilogy are the first MCU movies.
God. Could you sing Iron Man by Black Sabbath right now?
Bram. Bro-da-dun.
Yes, it is. No, it's not.
That's not how it goes. How's it go then? Oh, which one was I singing?
I don't know.
I was singing the one where I know this is also from Spider-Man Far From Home, the one before No Way Home, where he plays it and then Tom Holland's like, oh, I love Led Zeppelin.
That's AC/DC, PJ.
Whatever, PJ Darn. Is literally Tom Holland. Anyway. I am.
What else is there in this movie? This movie kind of felt really uneventful. I remember it much more fondly than I guess it was good. Like, Princess and the Pauper held up, but this one was just, it was alright.
This one, okay. I feel like, I know you said you liked the change, or not change, or just not having it have songs or music. I felt like it really just... It definitely made the whole vibe of the movie different.
There's a lot of Barbie movies that don't have songs. I think we just picked the two that have songs most prominently.
Yeah, I thought it was interesting.
Oh my god. The word interesting is now banned from Barbie before him. Okay, PJ. If you were to rate this movie out of 47
Bibbles?
No, PJ. Not Bibbles. 47 47 Iron Maiden Power Slave albums. What would you rate it?
Well, looking back at all the other ones, so let's do a quick recap of all the ones that we watched on this show. First, we watched The Princess and the Pauper. In my opinion, the best one.
Don't say anything about the songs in that movie.
Because the songs made it great. The second one we watched, The Diamond Castle, looks a lot like Hyrule Castle. And then the third one we watched,
Barbie
Fairytopia. And I forget the rankings I gave for the last, but this one, out of 47 thingies, what was it?
Iron Maiden albums, Power Slave, or Iron, you know what I mean.
That. Well, I actually enjoyed watching it with you, because we like kind of make fun of it. It's kind of like Mystery Science Theater 3000, where they like watch the movies and then make fun of it.
Mm-hmm.
Have you seen that?
I think I have.
Yeah. So that part's fun. The actual movie itself, it's like, it looks like somebody made it with, sadly, as I have to say, but it seems like somebody made it with just like a $2. Wait, how much money do I have in my, all the money I have, here's my wallet, my name's on that, all the money I have in this is how much, and I have some coins. This is how much this is the budget they used to,
you could buy a Barbie with how much money.
To make the Barbie movie. That was their budget. What to make the Barbie like? Movie.
$17?
Five.
16?
10.
Yeah, 16 and a half.
Yeah, so that's how much it was to make the Barbie movie. And. Give me back
PJ, not on camera.
Shut up, Andrew. That's weird. I want my wallet back. That's what I was getting at.
Yeah, but what if you...
Get your mind out of the gutter.
PJ, like... What if you were...
Oh, yeah. Wait. I think I forgot another coin, too.
What number would you rate it?
11.
11 out of 47 Iron Maiden albums being Power Slave.
Yes.
Okay. I would definitely give it probably... A 26 Iron Maiden albums Power Slave out of 47, because I felt that the villain was pretty weak, the characters were kind of weak, but I like Fibble.
What? I thought you said you didn't.
I hate Fibble, but I can't. I have this issue where sometimes I'm too much of a hater, so I'll like spend too much time interacting or like thinking about them, and then I become not a hater. It's happened like 3 or 4 times. It's a real issue.
Interesting.
Yeah. So that's it, I guess.
Wait. If this is the last episode of the series,
PJ, before you say anything,
what I would
if
just...
you say peace switch, I'm gonna cut it out.
That, but also, well, what's probably been your favorite moment of the whole time watching the movies?
Leave a comment below.
Yeah, leave your comment. But what was yours, Andrew? What do you think, like, what you got the most out of this whole experience?
I realized that Barbie is awesome, and I love Barbie movies. When I am in college, I'm going to watch Barbie movies with my friends.
I should buy you a Barbie doll when we graduate high school soon.
You should. Other than that, I think my favorite moment was probably just watching the first one. I mean, yeah. Editing has been so awful because my computer doesn't have like any, or it used to not have any space. I cleared it out a ton, but it used to have like this
much
space.
It builds up so fast.
It's so annoying!
Same. Well, when I have it, because mine's currently broken, so that's a whole other story.
PJ but... actually computer and it broke.
No, I didn't.
I'll cut that out.
No, but I think it's fun. I thought it was fun, like, the first time watching it when we were in the kitchen, I think. It was still the kitchen.
Yeah, I think the best part of these have definitely
the lights were off, and then we watched it with Ronan and Lena. That was a lot of fun.
The best parts of these have just been, like, watching the movie.
Yeah, and then, like, watching Dan's room a lot, and then with, like, Maddie and Cam not watching it.
Man, fuck Cam!
So.
I mean...
It's been good. It's been a
journey. I'd like to thank everyone who has been with us.
It's been
I don't know, a quarter of a year.
Yeah, it's been an interesting introduction.
PJ, you're off the show.
To you Barbie can't say for that. Me. So,
yeah.
Thank you, Andrew.
So, the Bodacious Babes will be bouncing buoyantly. I can't think of a word that means sign off.
Okay. Bye.
Bye. Thank you.
Wait. I lied. Leave a comment if you love Erica and if she's the best girl from any Barbie movie ever. I love her.
PJ is...
What?
A racist.